What's the matter with the place we live in? Didn't Mother Nature get it wrong? A rush to Delta in the name of changing. And dig it till it's dead and gone. What you gonna tell the children? Tell the spirit when the heart of the bayou bleeds. Well, there's a whole lot of something around here. There's been a whole lot of giving around here. We've seen a whole lot of hurting. But there's a whole lot of soul.
Welcome to Lucky 13 Curio Shop. Today we're going to talk about candles. Everyone who comes to the shop is not very familiar with the practices of South Louisiana Hoodoo. So we're doing these videos as a way to kind of give people a better understanding of what it is that we do. Candles are probably the most common thing that anybody who comes here is going to purchase or ask to have done. When a person lights candles for someone, they usually call it setting lights, or if they're burning them for themselves, I'm going to set a light for a job, or I'm going to set a light for my relationship, marriage. They're basically limitless as to what they can be burned for. There are a lot of different types of candles, and depending on what the person wants or how fast they want it to work, we'll determine exactly how or what candle needs to be burned and also how it's going to be burned. So we're going to start now and go over some of the basic candles that we carry here and what they're used for. All right, so one of the first types of candles, and the most common that we burn here at Lucky 13 Curio, are what's known as 7-day candles. Now, these don't actually burn for 7 days, but what they used to do in the old days is they would take one of these candles. These are sometimes referred to as novena candles or glass encased candles. And what they would do is they would mark along here with some paint or even some pieces of tape or something just to mark it, 7 notches. And they would let it burn down till it got to a notch, one for each day. Okay, and that's where they came up with the term 7-day. For the most part, these types of candles, when you burn for a spell or a ritual, you would light it and let it burn. These are safer to allow to burn because the flame is encased. The only thing that you have to be careful about is anything landing on top of them, anything hanging over them. You don't want any paper or anything above them, or curtains or anything like that, you know, to avoid fire hazards. But normally, what most people will do is they'll set a pot or a pan on a stove, and they'll put it on that with a little water at the bottom, just in case anything should happen, and they'll let it burn and set the lights. I've known people that have set them in their bathtubs and let them burn out. In a spare bathtub or even a sink, but any place is fine. Churches use these a lot, especially Catholic churches. So what you have here is what's called a single action 7-day candle. Single action means that it has one color. There are some rituals that require the use of several candles of varying colors. So for this one, like a red candle, you would burn for love or lust, relationship problems, to increase passion. But red can also be used to speed things up. So say you were doing something for a job and you needed a job quickly, you would burn a job candle along with a red candle to kind of add some fire to it and speed it up. So depending on what color you use, is determined by the purpose of the candle. Okay, so this is a 7-day candle, single action. They also have what's called double action, which you can see here is a red and a black. These are used primarily for reversals, to reverse anything that's been done. If you're having bad luck or you think somebody's setting lights on you, you can use this to reverse it back. These are also common for what's known as a shut up spell or a shut your mouth spell, to cause a person to basically shut up, stop gossiping. So this is a double action showing that what you would normally do for a reversal is set one red and one black. The black is to remove the negativity and the red is to speed up the process. And so in this one, you save a little money by getting a double action. You get the red and the black together instead of one red and one black. They also have what's known as triple action candles. As you can see here, a yellow, a green, and a gold. And this is what's called a road opener candle. But there are a lot of different triple action candles, and this is something to, instead of burning three separate candles, you burn one triple action candle. And road opener candles are used basically when you need to make changes in your life and you want to open the roads to a certain thing. This would be primarily for money and prosperity, good luck. In addition, you have what's known as jumbo taper candles, and we have a Lucky 13 Curio brand here. These are large taper candles, very commonly used in hoodoo work. And what you would do is engrave in here with a stylus or a needle or a nail, sometimes depending on the purpose involved. You would engrave what it is your desire is onto the candle, and then you would set it up and set the light and burn it. Now, these are not recommended to be left burning unattended ever, because they have a tendency to fall over sometimes. There's just a lot of things that can go wrong. It's a strong fire hazard. However, if you place them in a large high-sided pot with some water at the bottom, just a small layer of water, they're usually safe to burn and let them burn out. Another common one that we have that's a taper is a seven-knob candle, which you see here. And this is the same principle as a seven-day candle, what we talked about before, where they would set the notch. What these do is you burn one knob per day, and each day you pray for what it is you want while the candle is burning. So each one takes, depending on what your wish is, it'll take anywhere from 20 to 30 minutes for one knob, sometimes as long as an hour for one knob to burn down. And you would have to pray for that entire time period. And then you would extinguish the candle, and then you would do the next day, do the same thing. So that's a seven knob, what they call a wishing candle. We also have regular household taper candles, which are the same principle as the jumbos, except that they burn faster and they need to be repeated more often. We also sell cross candles, which are used for general blessings, as altar candles for people who have a permanent area where they burn their candles. They have an altar space. These are used to bring peace, prosperity, and they come in different colors depending on what you want to use them for. We do have these in red, we have them in green, we have them in white and black as well, to remove negativity. The black candles, contrary to what most people believe, black candles are not used exclusively to hex or curse a person. They're actually used to reverse and absorb or destroy negativity. So sometimes, you know, people see a black candle and they go, oh, you're doing evil things. That's not always the case. We also have skull candles. Now, these are used for a lot of different purposes. We have them in black, white, green, and red, depending on the purpose you want to use. Skull candles are used to bring good luck a lot of times, but most commonly in hoodoo practices, at least in South Louisiana, these candles are used to influence another person's mind. So if, say, a person, in this particular case, you have someone who doesn't want to go out and get a job, you get the green one because that has to do with money and finance, and you would take a heated nail and you would just hollow out a hole in the back here, and you would roll up on a piece of parchment, write down what it is you want the person to do. You would insert it into that hole, seal it up with the wax, and then burn the candle down. And you pray each day that that person does what it is that you're asking them to do. These are not very commonly sold because most people don't know what to do with them. Now, we are going to do another video to show you exactly how each one of these candles is used, because you also have to dress a candle, which means you have to anoint it with oils and sometimes powders. Sometimes they have to be set inside of a certain pan with vinegars or rose water, or depending on what it is that you want to do. So there's a whole series of things that have to be done. You can't just light the candle and say, hey, give me what I want, and expect it to work. There's a lot of process that goes in with it, a lot of one. Another candle that we have here is the cat candles. Now we have these in black, red, and green, depending on the purpose that you want. Cat candles are burned generally for good luck in different areas. Red, of course, for love, black to remove negativity, and green to bring good luck for money. These are fairly common. Most people still don't know how to use the cat candles. And we talked about reversibles, and we have some jumbo tapers here. These are reversibles. They're actually red on the inside, black on the outside. And it has the same principle as a blockbuster or a reversible candle to remove hexes or curses or bad luck. And that's what these are used for primarily. We also have what are known as figure candles. Here we have a male figure candle and we have a female reversible figure candle. So if you have someone who is in a crossed condition and they're a female or a male, these are both reversibles. If you look at the bottom there, you can see they're red on the inside, black on the outside. These are to remove curses or hexes or bad luck or illness or whatever it is that's afflicting the person. And you would burn these, you would, on the back of the candle, or depending on if their person is sick, say they're having a heart problem, you would put certain symbols on the heart, anoint it with healing oils, and set it up in a special place with certain waters and washes and all these things, and you would burn it for them to heal them. And that's mostly what these are used for. And then we have what's known as a breakup candle. So if you have people, in a lot of cases, people who are just not good for one another and they're constantly arguing, fighting, but they don't want to leave each other and they have problems leaving each other. We have that situation where people will come to us and they say, you know, I'm in a bad relationship and I just want to get out of it, but I don't want to fight or I don't want to have any problems. They would burn one of these candles, one representing the male partner, one representing the female partner. In the case of people who are same sex, you would have to get two of the same ones because unfortunately they don't make these together in those, but it could still be done using two males or two females depending on the nature of the relationship. And you would dress this in certain oils and powders and washes in order to make that happen. And what this does, even though it may sound like a breakup candle sounds like a negative thing, it's used by people who want to get out of relationships without it becoming negative. So it is brought about for a purpose that is positive and constructive, that each person go and find something better in their lives instead of hanging on and being in a negative environment. So those are the majority of the candles that we sell here at Lucky 13 Curio. We have a lot of other products and we're going to cover each of them in turn. But in the meantime, if you have any other questions about the different types of candles that we carry here or how to use them or if you want to order them, just give us a call. Our number is area code 504-270-1313, or you can send us an instant message on Facebook at Gypsy's Lucky 13 Curio on Facebook. And that's it. Thank you for listening.